the series of class 4 will read about the story of a tree which was a fir tree and it had different kinds of leaves that it gave to the person who asked for it, and then you'll come to know what will happen later. Let us read and enjoy this story and do the exercises also.
The Little Fir Tree. Shetty the magician was returning home when all of a sudden it began to rain. It rained heavily. Shetty looked around for shelter and saw a pretty little fir tree. He ran towards it as fast as he could. This is a magician. You can see a magic wand in his hand, and it was a fir tree, and this Shetty, he was a magician. He was returning back home when it began to rain, and when it rained heavily, Shetty took shelter under this fir tree as fast as he could. Shelter means किसी भी चीज़ के अंदर नीचे या किसी कहीं भी सहारा लेना, थोड़ी देर के लिए अपने आप को वो करना, प्रोटेक्शन देना. Soon the rain stopped. Shetty was happy that he did not get wet. Now Shetty, as he had taken shelter under this tree, so he did not get wet. No raindrop fell on him and his clothes, they didn't get wet. When the rain stopped, Shetty said, "Thank you. You have been kind to me." You see, there is a comma and I stopped here. Shetty said to the tree, "You have been very kind to me. I would like to reward you. Ask for 4 wishes and I'll grant them," said the magician. Now the magician granted his 4 wishes. Now let's see what happened. The sad fir tree had leaves like needles and no birds ever made their nests on it. So it said, "I wish I had green leaves like my other friends." Now that little fir tree, it asked Shetty that it had needle. You see, it has needle-like leaves. So it said, "I want green leaves so that birds make nest on me." Next morning, its wish was granted. Soon a goat came along and ate all the green leaves. "Oh dear," said the fir tree, "I wish I had gold leaves, as goats do not eat gold leaves." Now what happened? This goat, next day the tree's wish came into effect and it had got this green leaves. Then a goat came and ate all its leaves, and the fir tree thought that it had gold leaves, at least goat could not eat it. When the little fir tree woke up the next morning, it was surprised to see gold leaves. "How happy I am," it said. A man came along and stole the gold leaves. Now you see, the wish was granted and these leaves have been made of gold now. But what happened? A thief came and stole the gold leaves. "I wish I had glass leaves instead. Men do not steal glass leaves." The next day, its glass leaves shone in the bright sun. "How happy I am," it said. At night, the wind blew. All the glass leaves broke. Now, this fir tree thought that it had glass leaves. But when the wind blew, all its glass leaves, they fell down. They broke. And what happened? "Oh dear," said the fir tree, "I like my old needle-like leaves best. For ghosts do not eat them. No man can steal them. The wind will do them no harm." Now the fir tree wished that it had its old needle-like leaves. They were the best for him. Ghosts did not eat them. No man stole that those leaves. Wind did not blew them. Wind did not do any harm to them. The tree went to sleep. When it woke up the next morning, it had all its needles back again. Now, next day, it had its needle-like leaves back. "Oh, I never was so happy, said the little fir tree. And the fir tree was very happy to see that it had its needle-like leaves back. The magician had given him his leaves back. Now in this story was the moral that whatever God has given to us, He has given it because of a purpose. And we should never, we should be thankful for that, and we should never just get irritated. Oh, I should not have got this. I deserve something better. No, whatever we deserved, God gave us. Now here are the new words. Pretty means beautiful. Needles, you know needles, some pretty instrument type of thing. Leaves, gold, stole. Stole is the past tense of steal. You see? Now, reading is fun. Take right the correct answer. The pretty little fir tree was happy with gold leaves. But, what happened? But, the pretty little fir tree was happy with gold leaves. Now, he had gold leaves, but he was happy. But what happened? A man stole them. The fir tree was sad. Why was it sad? Because it had yellow leaves? No, because it had needle-like leaves. It was sad because of this. The fir tree was not happy with the gold leaves because a man stole them. Gold leaves, right? Now, by changing the circle word to its opposite, rewrite these sentences. We have to change, write the antonyms of these words, the circle words. I carry a light bag to school every day. Now, light is circled. So, the opposite of light is heavy. The sentence became, I carry a heavy bag to school every day. Rina won the race. One, opposite of one is lost. Rina lost the race. I love eating vegetables. Opposite of love is, I hate eating vegetables. This glass of milk is full. Full, opposite of full is empty. This glass of milk is empty. The old man is wise. The opposite of wise is foolish. The old man is foolish. Now give the opposites of the words below by adding an or em. I told you about the prefixes and suffixes. Prefixes are put before a word. Suffixes are put at the end of the word. Now here we have to add an or em. These are the suffixes that will be put before the word to make it a meaningful word, and those adding an or em will give us the opposite of the given word. Happy, unhappy. Polite, impolite. Seen, unseen. Proper, improper. Lucky, unlucky. Possible, impossible. Important, unimportant. Important is a word with M in itself. So, unimportant. Perfect, imperfect. Healthy, unhealthy. Safe, unsafe. Patient, impatient. Pure, impure. This exercise, Rita loved her dog Sheru every day. Sheru would go out of the house and come back himself. But one day he did not come home. Rita looked everywhere for him. Tears rolled down her cheeks. Sheru was lost. He was nowhere to be found. Rita was crying. When she reached home, she got into her bed. All of a sudden, something jumped on her. Can you guess who it was? Rita was very happy. You have to give the opposites of the words in blue. The blue words given, they are to be written in opposites. Now, Rita hated her dog Sheru. Loved, opposite of loved is hated. Rita, don't go for the meaning. Just we have to rewrite these sentences using the antonyms of the words in blue. Rita hated her dog Sheru. Every day Sheru would go out. Opposite of go out will be come back. Sheru would come back into the house and go back himself. But one day he did not come home. Rita looked nowhere. Opposite of everywhere is nowhere for him. Tears rolled down her cheeks. Tears rolled up her cheeks. Sheru was found. He was everywhere to be found. Rita was laughing when she reached home. She got into her bed. All of a sudden, something jumped on her. Can you guess who it was? Rita was very sad. We have to write the opposites of these words. Now, let's write. Rewrite the passage below using capital letters where necessary. We have done punctuation earlier also. One may, this one, capital O, one Saturday afternoon, comma, Amarjeet. Name of a person is always written with capital letter, capital, Amarjeet. And his little sister, Rani. Rani again is the name of a girl. Rani, capital R, went for a picnic to India. Capital I, India Gate, capital G, full stop. There, capital T, there they saw ducks, water, and their friend Raj. Raj again would be written in capital. Oh dear. Oh dear may O will be capital. Oh dear. Oh may exclamation. Oh dear, comma. And this is a word that, so this will be written like this. Oh dear, comma, said the fir tree. Full stop. I like my old needle-like leaves best. Now again it is a direct speech, inverted commas begin, full stop. I like my old needle-like leaves best, for ghosts don't eat them and no man can steal them. Full stop and inverted commas closed. This way you have to write. Here, look at the picture below. In the yellow box, there are 8 things. What things? Ducks, mat, dog, girl, boy, tree, fountain, flowers. You can see 6 of them in the picture. We can see 6 of them in the picture. You cannot see the other 2. Write down the 4 things that you can see. Okay, you'll have to write. What 4 things do you see? What do we see? Do we see ducks? Yes. Mat? Yes. Dog? Do we see dog? No. Girl? Yes. Here's a girl. Boy? No. Tree? Yes. Fountain? No. Flowers? Yes. Look at the picture again. Describe the picture. So, when we'll describe the pictures, we can take the these words also into use. We can go like this. This is a picnic scene. There are trees all around. It is greenery everywhere. The flowers are blooming. Birds are chirping. Ducks are swimming in the pond. A baby girl wants to have food. Father protects the child. Father is with the child. They have bananas and other food material also. Ball is also kept for playing. And this is a lovely picnic scene. Right? This way we can do this. Now this is, Ajit loved flowers. He always wanted to have a garden for himself. And why we can have a garden in a dish? You can prepare. This is an activity for you. You can prepare a garden in a dish, in a tire, or any vegetable garden you can do at your home. In simple glasses or boxes you can do. In the shoe boxes, in the thermocol boxes that come. Now, glass breaks easily when it is dropped. Do you think a mud flower pot, glass spoon, a wooden table, a plastic cup, books, or your plastic water bottle can break easily? Circle the things that can. You have to circle the things that can break. Spoon? No. Table? No. Flower pot? Yes. Plastic cup? Water bottle? No. Books? No. Cup? Yes. Now, which of the following actions would make others happy or unhappy? Now, respecting elders, happy. Not saying thank you, unhappy. Being polite, happy. Playing with friends, happy. Visiting a sick friend, happy. Not sharing, unhappy. Watching television all day, unhappy. Mama ko, papa ko gussa aata hai na jab aap sara din television dekhte ho. You don't have to watch television and stick to mobiles or computers all throughout the day. You should play outside. Telling lies, unhappy. Being greedy, lalchi hona, unhappy caring of pets, happy getting angry easily, unhappy being honest, happy. Here, let's listen, read and write. There was a thick jungle with beautiful green trees and birds. Quail was singing happily. Suddenly, she heard someone crying. It was her friend, the peacock. She flew to him and asked. Now, quail, this cuckoo. What do we call quail in English? Cuckoo. Cuckoo was singing happily. And what does cuckoo sing like? Coo, coo. She does like that. Cuckoo heard someone crying. It was a peacock. So cuckoo asked, "Why are you crying?" Peacock said, "I hate myself. I have such ugly feet." Actually, peacock dances so beautifully, but one thing God did not give peacock was beautiful feet. Feet of peacock are generally not so good to look at. So this peacock was crying. Some things make you feel happy, some things make you feel sad. Write a poem on the picture. You can write a poem on this picture. If you can try it. Here's it given. Let's make a word tree. This is how you will do. This is a craft work. Roll the paper like this. Cut it into pieces and then you can fold them. This is the way it has been given. Write words related to leaves on the trees and make a word tree. You have to write words related to leaves on the word tree. Now make sentences with these words. This is a fun activity and you can do it. Okay? All the best.